दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 6 हाउ थिंग्स चेंज इन विच वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन. द पेज नंबर इज 93 एंड दिस इज द मॉड्यूल 4. इन दिस इंटरेक्टिव वीडियो सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन, हाउ द रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन इज फॉर्म्ड, what is the main cause behind forming the rusting of iron, what is the chemical equation of the rusting of iron, what is the effect of or the result of the formation of rusting of iron on the surface of iron, and what are the different preventive measures to save the iron from getting rusted, such as by coating, by galvanization and by anodization. These are the three different preventive measures that we can take against the rusting of iron. And finally, we should also know what is the meaning of alloy and the example of the alloy. Rusting of iron. In this phrase, rusting of iron, the word rusting means brownish, powdery substance. The coat of brownish, powdery substance on the surface of iron. This is the meaning of rusting. Rusting means getting coated of brownish powdery substance on the surface of the iron. And rusting of iron, in Bengali we can say the jong laga. This is the most common chemical combination reaction in which the iron combines with oxygen of air in the presence of the moisture. And the main cause behind the rusting of iron on the surface of iron is the rusting of iron is only taken place in the presence of air and in the presence of moisture. But the rusting of iron doesn't take place in the absence of air and in absence of the moisture. These are the two important factors, the air, oxygen, and the moisture, this is the H2O. These two are the responsible factor for the formation of the rusting of iron on the surface of iron. And I am sure that you have observed the scrap iron nails, the iron doors or the gates or the different iron tools which get coated with the brownish powdery substance, and this is the rusting. And this brownish powder substance is called the rust, or we can say the ferric oxide, this one Fe2O3H2O, ferric, iron ferric oxide. And the process of getting rusted on the surface of iron, it is called the rusting. The important characteristic of rusting of iron, the chemical combination reaction, is it is an irreversible, I repeat, it is an irreversible chemical change. And the ultimate result or the adversarial effect of rusting of iron on the surface of iron is the whole iron gets damaged due to the formation of the brownish powdery substance called the rust. And the chemical equation of the rusting of iron on the surface of iron is, this is the Fe iron, it gets combined with oxygen of air and the moisture H2O. And then finally it produced or it gives the new substance called the hydrated iron oxide or the rust, Fe2O3H2O. This is the iron oxide, the rust. Now, if the rust from the surface of the rusted iron object is corroded by scraping, then we will find ourselves that the iron loses its shininess due to the rust formed on the surface of the iron. And when this rust on the surface of the iron is corroded by scraping, the iron, it gets lost its shininess, and as a result, eventually the iron lost its shininess because of the formation of the rust on the surface of the iron. And when the rusting gets so deeper and deeper, the whole of iron gets converted to the powdery mass and the object gets totally wasted. It has been proved that the rusting is very much rapid in the saline seawater. Than the normal water. Now, what are the different preventive measures that can be taken against the rusting of iron? Number one, by coating. If the iron objects are coated with paints, grease, oil, or red lead oxide, we can easily prevent the rusting of iron on the surface of metal, iron. The another method is called galvanization. This is another preventive measure against the rusting of iron. Now we have to know what is the meaning of the galvanization. It is the process of depositing a layer of zinc on the iron surface is called simply the galvanization process. In this process, the zinc is used because zinc is not affected by the moisture or water. Hence, in this galvanization process, the preventive measure acts against the rusting of iron. By galvanization, the iron pipes, corrugated iron sheets, etc. are galvanized with which metal? Answer is zinc metal. And galvanization is used for protecting the iron pipes from getting damaged by the formation of rusting or rust on the surface of the iron. Whereas there are different other tools, such as the tools of cars, the bicycles, the furnitures, water taps, bathroom fittings, etc., are coated with the nickel and the chromium plating. This is also the process of galvanization by using nickel and the chromium. Nowadays, the plastic coating, this is another method, preventive method, is being used for preventing the fridge, air conditioner, blenders, juicers, grinders, etc. which are made mainly from iron are coated with this plastic. The method of using the plastic coating is very much cheaper and easier method than the galvanization and the coating preventive method. The another method is called the anodization, and in this process the raw aluminium is coated with a thick layer of aluminium oxide by the process of electrolysis. And this anodization process is used as a preventive measure for the aluminium metal, because the aluminium metal reacts with the oxygen of air and form a uniform layer of aluminium oxide on the surface of it, which is corrosive in nature, but it is the self-protective layer. And this self-protective layer, it does not allow the oxidation of the metal to go further deep into the metal. And for this reason, the raw aluminium is to be coated with the thick layer of aluminium oxide by the process of electrolysis. And this is called the anodization. This anodization process is also taken as a preventive measure against the rusting of iron or the rusting of aluminium. What is an alloy? An alloy, it is formed by making different metals or the non-metals. The example of alloy is the stainless steel. It is the alloy made by mixing ICCNM, iron, carbon, chromium, nickel, and the manganese. In the stainless steel, the alloy, carbon is although used, but carbon is not the metal. But its presence in the alloy of stainless steel as a part of the iron. And this, for this reason, the stainless steel, the alloy, does not get rusted. With this last discussion of this chapter, the chapter is concluded. You are advised to revise again and again this chapter for your second time examination. Thanks for watching this video.